So let me explain you what the circuit is. So we have n-channel MOSFET, and to that we have given input voltage VGS, which is the DC voltage, and also we have a drain to source voltage, that is VDD. The value is VDD, it is nothing but VDS, because this is the drain and source. Okay, we have VDS voltage and VGS voltage. For now, just ignore this part, that is VGS. So just think why we have given the voltage VGS and VDS to the MOSFET. It is because we want MOSFET to be operated in a certain region. So that region is, you can see it here. The first thing, which is the characteristics of ID versus VGS, that is how the DC current ID varies with respect to VGS, and another plot which is ID, which shows ID versus VDS, that is how the drain current varies with respect to VDS. So these are the two characteristics. So by applying proper value of voltages, that is VGS and VDS, we operate in a certain region in this characteristics. Okay, for example, this is VT. Say VT of MOSFET is 0.5 volts, and VGS is 2 volts. Okay, it means this is VT and we are operating it somewhere here. Okay, so this is VGS is equal to 2 volts, and also there is something called as VDS. So say if VDS is equal to 3 volts, then the operating point will be say here. Okay, so with these voltages we will come to know in which region we are operating. Okay, one on input side, one the other on output. Okay, with these values right now we are operating here and here. Okay, that is one in input characteristics I have shown where we are, because VGS 2 volts means here. Okay, so with this much VGS there will be a current which is magnitude is shown on the y-axis. Okay, if VGS is equal to 2 volts and VDS is equal to 3 volts, the current ID, which is same here and here, say it may be 2 milliamps. Okay, so that is given in both the characteristics, and we have deduced it from the voltages VGS and VDS. So this point which I have highlighted in both input and output characteristics is called as operating point Q. Okay, this depends on VGS and VDS. Okay, so if VGS is greater than VT, let me write it again. So if VGS is greater than VT and VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT, the MOSFET is said to be operating in saturation mode. There are other two modes, which is cutoff and triode. You can look out for that, the different modes in the separate textbook. Okay. Right now you concentrate on the fact that we are right now operating in saturation mode, because VDS from these values, VGS is of course greater than VT, so first condition is satisfied. Second is VDS, that is 3 volt, should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT, that is 2 minus 0.5, which is 3 of course is greater than or equal to 1.5. So this MOSFET is operating in saturation region. Okay, so there are different benefits by operating in say saturation region and triode. There is a cutoff, another mode which is of no use. Okay, so if the MOSFET is operating in saturation mode, then it is a very good region, because we'll get very high gain for the input AC signals. Okay, so if the MOSFET is operating in saturation mode, it can act as amplifier. Okay, so the main purpose or the primary purpose of any MOSFET is to act as an amplifier for a small signals. So that's the primary purpose. So that is served only when the MOSFET is operated in the saturation mode. That is when these conditions are met. Okay, so that is met when we are in the this region. Okay, the as you can see, this is a flat characteristic here after some point. So this is the saturation region, this point. Okay, you cannot make out from only input characteristics, so you have to look at output characteristics as well. One thing should be VGA should be greater than VT, so that you can see it here, somewhere here and here. So we should be operating in this region as well as this region for the MOSFET to be in saturation mode or region, whatever. Okay, so we saw that this operating point depends on VGS, because VGS will tell if it is 2 volts, the operating point is here. If VGS was say 0.4 volt, the operating point would be somewhere here. Okay, and so the operating point first of all depends on VGS and also on VDS. Say if VDS was say 1 volt, then we would be operating somewhere here. Okay, so even that is the one of the parameter for the this operating point, I mean where the point lies in the region. So VGS and VDS decide where we are operating. Okay, so we got to know that. Now this is MOSFET is already set to be an amplifier because we have already provided the value of VGS and VDS. Now all we want to know is all we want to do is provide a signal which is say 1 milliamps or 1 millivolt and get output which is 2 millivolt. Okay, so this is a input signal, so it should be voltage say 1 millivolt. Your output we are expecting should be 3 millivolts or 2 millivolts. That is, we want amplified version of the input AC signal. Okay, so that's why this circuit is used for that. Now we know the operating point also, so let's now concentrate on modeling this circuit, okay, to arrive at the small signal model of MOSFET. Sorry for explaining all these things. If you know this, I'll recommend to skip at this point. I'll provide this in description so you can so we already know the current equation of MOSFET, that is ID. I capital I capital D is equal to mu n Cox W by 2L capital V capital GS minus VT square into 1 plus lambda PDS. This is capital V capital DS. Now since we had introduced small signal on top of VGS, that is DC signal VGS, and we have another small signal voltage, that is small v small gs. So this small signal also produced another current component, small I and small d. Okay, so now equation 1 will differ. We have total drain current ID is equal to ID plus ID, that is capital I capital E plus small I small d. So this is the new term, small I capital D is equal to mu n C aux W upon 2L. This will be same, and also the VGS, it was earlier only the DC voltage VGS. Now since we have another small signal input added to this, we have a new term for this capital V capital GS. Okay, so this gets replaced by small v capital GS. So this small v capital GS is equal to V capital GS plus small v small GS. Okay, this is the DC plus this is AC, small signal, okay, minus VT square. And before proceeding with this term, we'll understand that lambda VDS is usually much smaller than 1. So this component can be ignored for now, okay. In fact, it can be ignored for any sort of analysis unless you want a detailed analysis. So in this example or video, we'll ignore this component, okay. So we are left with only this equation. Let me highlight and write it again. That is small I small d is equal to mu n C aux W upon 2L small v capital GS minus VT whole square. Okay, so VT is the threshold voltage of MOSFET. So this is the new current equation of MOSFET. Let's call it as 2, and where small I capital D is equal to sum of DC current plus AC current, and VGS is sum of DC voltage VGS plus small signal voltage small v small GS. Okay, so this is the current equation. Okay, so this is very important, because now what we are going to do is use Taylor series to expand this equation to and arrive finally at the small signal model of this MOSFET. Okay, small signal model of the MOSFET, primarily we are interested in that. So let's see step by step. Now next step, as I said, is to apply Taylor series on this equation. So I think many must have forgotten what is Taylor series, because it would have been taught in the first year of engineering or in your plus two. So let me revise for this Taylor series and then expand this equation to in terms of Taylor series. Okay, so this is the Taylor series, which says function f of x can be expanded in this fashion around the operating point A. So f of x is equal to f of a plus first derivative of x at a into x minus a plus second derivative of f of x with the, at the point a upon 2 factorial into x minus a whole square, so on. Okay, so in this case our function f of x is id. Okay, so this id, as you can see from the equation, it is mu n c aux w upon 2l small v and capital GS minus VT the whole square. So ID is depending only on VGS, because only this is getting changed. These are all constants. That is, this is capacitance, it is constant. Width and length, that is geometry, is constant. Threshold voltage of MOSFET is also constant. Okay, so rest all are constant. So the function f of x will be ID. So this small I capital D is depending only on the voltage VGS, that is sum of DC plus AC signal. Okay, so I have given it here. So in this case the x becomes small v and capital GS, and the operating point of MOSFET, as we all know, that it is Q, which depends on DC voltages VGS and VDS. Like I said before, these two voltages determine where we are in the input output characteristics. Okay, but once we are in already in the saturation mode, that is, once we are sure that the MOSFET is operating in saturation mode, it means the VDS is greater than VGS minus VT. So we have already set it with the appropriate voltage, and we have omitted that part from the current equation because lambda VDS was much lesser than 1. Okay. Since our current is dependent on only VGS, we'll skip the part where the operating point is dependent on VDS. Okay. Because we already know that MOSFET is in the saturation region. Okay. So let's ignore this and concentrate only on VGS, because the MOSFET is already in saturation region with input output ID versus VGS characteristics. We can tell what is the value of ID for this VGS. Okay, and since it is in saturation mode, the VDS is fixed, so it will play its role, but we do not want to see that in this characteristics. Okay, let me not explain this too much, so it will be confusing for you. What I mean to say is, in the current equation we didn't have VDS part, so let's remove that VDS component from operating point as well, because we are interested in Taylor series expansion of ID. Since it doesn't have VDS, the operating point, that is this A, need not have VDS. Okay, so keeping that in mind, the operating point now becomes only VGS, capital V, capital GS. Okay, so we have X is equal to small V capital GS, which is equal to capital VGS plus VGS, and A is capital VGS. So this is DC, this is DC plus AC. Now we all know the what are the values of A and X. Okay, we can apply this Taylor series to this current equation. Okay, so ID becomes small I capital D is equal to F of A. F of A means small I, that is this ID at VGS, this is cap small V, capital GS is equal to VGS. So that is F of A, which means what is the value of ID when voltage is just pure DC. So at that time the current also will be only component of DC, so the current will be only DC component. Okay, since the voltage is only DC component, so that is F of A. We get the DC component ID. Okay, so moving on, we have X minus A. So X is sum of DC plus AC. We are subtracting the DC component, so we get small V small GS, okay, into F dash of A. Now F dash of A can be calculated as, so we'll use partial derivative, that is del ID upon del small v capital GS at operating point Q. Okay, so del ID upon del VGS at operating point Q. So this becomes and plus this other terms. Okay, since we are dealing with only small signal voltages, we can neglect this part, okay, from here. So that's the whole point of applying Taylor series. The small signal components, that is VGS, is very small, that is this AC signal is very small, these components can be ignored, so we'll just stop at here. So that's the whole point of Taylor series expansion, as I said before. we had a equation. So with the help of Taylor series, we expanded and simplified up to the point where after that it is not needed because it becomes negligible. So we are at that point. So, and also we have this del ID upon del VGS, which is transconductance of MOSFET, so which we saw in the previous video, because this term is nothing but the variation of the drain current with respect to the input voltage at a given operating point of the MOSFET. So we called this as GM. So now our new current equation becomes, with the help of Taylor series, small I capital D is equal to ID plus transconductance of MOSFET into small V small GS, that is VC component of the signal. Sorry, it is a AC signal or small signal. Okay, so small I small D is equal to capital I capital D plus GM times small V and GS. Okay, so please note that small V small GS is AC, capital V capital GS is DC, and small V capital GS is equal to sum of AC plus DC. It may look same in the video, but concentrate on what I am saying and also look at this terms. GS is small here and it is capital here, and V is little have tilted, so that it is sum of AC plus DC. So make sure that it is looking different from the above one. Okay, now what we have is small I capital D is equal to ID plus GM VGS. Okay, and this is a small signal as I said. Now let's simplify this and see where we are at the small signal modeling of the MOSFET. Okay, we have small I capital D is equal to capital ID plus GM into VGS. So this we got from the Taylor series expansion of MOSFET current ID, which is equal to mu n Cox W upon 2L small V capital GS minus VT whole square. Okay, so this current is because of both DC voltage plus AC voltage. Okay, hence it depends on both DC and AC, so the current component also will be sum of DC plus AC. Okay, so after the Taylor series expansion of this equation, we arrive at this. Okay, ID is equal to ID plus GM into VGS. Before that, we know that this is sum of DC current plus AC. So let's substitute this in this equation. Then what will happen is it will become ID plus ID is equal to capital I capital D plus GM into VGS. So this can be cancelled. Now we arrived at a very important conclusion, that is small signal current ID is equal to transconductance into small signal voltage VGS. Okay, so this we got only after the Taylor series expansion of this circuit. Otherwise we would not have known that this small signal component is GM times VGS. Okay, so thanks to Taylor series and its importance, we arrived at this equation. Okay, and even in Taylor series we neglected some component, that is the Taylor series expansion had many terms such as f double dash of a upon 2 factorial into x minus a whole square. Since VGS is really small, it may be very less to or equal to 1, it is negligible in fact, so we neglected this component. Okay, so the approximation was right and Taylor series works, so you can be sure of that. So from that Taylor series expansion, we got ID is equal to GM times VGS. Now coming to the circuit, we need small signal model from this circuit. Okay, so when we say small signal, it is only AC signals and no DC component. Okay, so apply no DC, it means we have VGS, so it becomes short 0 volt, VDS also will become 0 volt. So we have only VGS, which is AC signal, and this ID will be equal to only small signal component, small I small d. So DC current also will become 0. Okay, so the new MOSFET circuit will look something like this. This is ground, this is also ground, and we have only VGS. Okay, and this is small I small d. Okay, so this is the small signal component. Now let's say this is, call it as gate, drain and source, because both gate is connecting to source and the drain is connecting to source. Okay, so this is G, this is D and this is S. So at gate to source we have small v, small gs, and from drain to source, that is drain to source, there is a current flowing ID which is equal to gm times vgs. Hence we get voltage controlled current source, which is gm times vgs. Okay, let me draw it again. So sorry, that was very small. I think you guys were not able to see. So here is the small signal model from this circuit. Okay, only small signals are present. So there is a small signal voltage VGS which produces current ID, which is equal to GM times VGS. Okay, so the model can be drawn like this. So this is gate, this is source and drain. Since source is common to both gate and drain, I have drawn here, or we have drawn historically. So between gate and source there is small signal voltage VGS. This produces current ID in the MOSFET, okay, which flows from drain to source. Okay, so this is GM times VGS, this is equal to ID. So this whole thing is the small signal model of this MOSFET. Okay, and this gate to source is nothing but the input. Okay, so that is how we get the component GM into VGS in the small signal model of MOSFET. So there are other terms which come here in parallel to GM into VGS. Note that the current is called as voltage controlled current source. Okay, so this is voltage controlled. Depending upon VGS, the current ID changes by the factor GM, which is the transconductance of MOSFET. Okay, so this is how you arrive at the small signal model. As I said, there are other components which come from drain, between drain to source. So that we'll try to add it in the next video. Okay, for now I hope it is clear. It was very lengthy, but take time and understand. If you have any doubts, please use the comment section. So understanding with the help of mathematics is very important, because that's how these models are built, and these models play a very great role in the signal amplification factor and how the MOSFET acts as amplifier, etc. Okay, Now in this video, the Taylor series was the major thing which helped us to arrive at this point. Okay, so Taylor series, you must thank to Taylor for his wonderful mathematical analysis that any function can be expanded as f around the point a as f of a plus f dash of a into x minus a and so on. Okay, so thanks guys. If you like our videos, please subscribe and also tell to your friends that there is a channel which is explaining in depth, and ask also them to subscribe so that they also get the knowledge of all these things. Okay, so see you soon guys. Thank you very much.